Hello mga students, allow me through this very short, no, brief video lecture, siguro baka wala pa nga itong 5 minutes, I don't know if gaano ito katagal aabutin, but allow me to make a discussion, a simple comparison, or should I say a reconciliation between the present value factor na ginagamit po natin sa annuity due at saka yung sa mga ordinary annuity. Because this is common in for classroom purposes po, no? Especially when tayo yung pinapahanap ng mga present value factor in computing for the present value of a particular, yung mga ano, no, periodic payments. Okay? So dito po kasi nagkakaroon tayo ng distinction between the annuity due and the ordinary annuity in terms of the timing of the payment as represented by this visual here. So kung makikita po ninyo ano, we have N and N plus 1. Consider your N as the year 0 and your N plus 1 as your year 1. Okay? Kung o kaya naman, sabihin na natin na ngayon ay January 1. This is your N. And then yung December 31 mo is your N plus 1. Okay? Why? Because marami pong mga instances, lalo na kapag involve yung mga present value computations, no, na kinakailangan nating i-identify yung tamang present value factor. Sometimes we do not need to compute for it. Pinipresent lang po sa atin or available po sa atin yung mga present value factor table and we are allowed to find it. But of course, no, in finding it, hindi minsan available yung ano, no, hindi ito yung spoon feed na ibibigay na sa iyo lahat talaga. Sometimes pagpipilian tayo, no, tatanungin ka or bibigyan ka ng option. Ito yung present value factor ng annuity due. Ito naman yung present value factor ng ordinary annuity. Tapos minsan bibigyan ka ng different rates. Lalong-lalo na kapag meron tayong ano, no, comparison or binigay sa atin yung implicit interest rate at saka yung mga incremental borrowing rate. So we have to identify which is which. Alin sa mga rates, no, at alin yung tamang present value factor. I hope this will ano, no, clarify some of the misunderstandings of the other students. Na medyo nalilito, ano, alin ba dapat? Kasi on our understanding, and allow me to ano, no, clarify this to everyone, when we are talking of annuity due, the payment is made at the beginning of the period. Kaya nga po makikita ninyo dito, yung payment ay nandito sa umpisa. Samantalang, for ordinary annuity, the payment is made at the end of the period. Kaya nandito naman siya sa ating visual. Minsan, no, baka magtaka tayo kasi sa mga problems, no, sa mga cases, when we check the present value factor na ginagamit, we know that the example is an annuity due, pero ang ginagamit naman po ay present value factor using an ordinary annuity. How do we reconcile it? Paano natin masasabi kung tama ba ito or mali? Kasi remember, annuity due, meron itong separate na ano, no, present value table. Yung ordinary annuity, meron din itong separate na present value table, no? So tama ba or mali? Okay? Now, it lies on the proper understanding of the rates and the period. Meron ako ditong simple na present value factor reconciliation. Okay? Para mas lubusan po natin na maintindihan, meron akong simple na illustration po dito, no? Hindi na natin kailangan ng mahaba-haba ng computation actually, no? Kailangan lang natin ng present value factor table kasi hindi na naman, wag na natin dito computan yung present value talaga. Pakita lang natin yung difference sa mga factors, no, present value factors. Assuming a 2-year contract with an annual payment of 100,000 each, payable at the beginning of each year using a 10% interest rate. So dito makikita mo, oy, dalawang taon. Annual payment, okay, 100,000 each. Kailan binabayaran? At the beginning of each year. Or sometimes, pwedeng it will be presented as it will be payable on January 1 of each year. Okay? Beginning on, let's say, January 1, 2022. Parang ganun, ano? So meron tayong advance payment. January 1 yung start ng ating contract. For example, January 1, 2022. Tapos ang first payment is January 1, 2022. So meron tayong advance payment, no? Cash advance. Not necessarily in the context of cash advance, but I mean cash payment made in advance, ano? Kasi hindi pa naman talaga tayo nakakapagtapos ng isang taon, binayaran na natin yung isang taon. So that is why we are paying it in advance. Okay, so in the our timeline, ginawa ko ito dalawang taon para nakikita natin ano yung pinaka yung bigger picture. So we have January 1, assuming, okay, 20XX, okay, December 31, 20XX, and then we have January 1 of the following year, no? January 1, 20X plus 1, and December 31, 20X plus 1. So we, if we are talking of January 1, 2022, yung X plus 1 mo is 2023. Kailan yung timing ng payment? January 1, ano? At the beginning of each year. So this is the first payment. Kung dalawang taon lang naman yung kontrata, kailan yung susunod na payment? It will be made January 1 of the following year. So yung ating line dito, ano, this will separate our time periods for the year, okay, 20XX, and for the year 20XX plus 1. Okay, now, pag ganito, ano, alam natin, nakita natin dito, payable at the beginning of each year, uy, annuity due yan. Sir, sure ako, annuity due yan. Ang payment kasi will be made at the beginning of each year. Now, anong gagawin ko? Okay? If pinapa-compute sa atin yung present value present value ng 100,000 for 2 years, no? Hanapin natin. Puntahan po natin yung present value table for annuity due applying a 10% interest rate. Pero dito, sir, anong gagamitin ko? 1 period or 2 periods? Now tignan po ninyo ito. The present value factor annuity due at 10% in 2 years. Because annuity due po ito, dalawang taon, nagkataon lang na annuity due siya, ang payment is at the beginning, no? Kaya 2 years pa rin yan or 2 periods. At makikita po ninyo, applying a 10%, no? Hanapin po ninyo yung column for the 10%, 2 periods, makikita po ninyo itong 1.9091. Okay, you can go ahead. You can check your present value table. Either sa mga libro po ninyo or you can search online. It will be available. It will be visible to you. So just you can confirm that this is indeed for present value factor for annuity due at 10% in 2 periods, not 2 years. Okay, 1.1991. Now, syempre, okay, we are paying in advance. This is the beginning of our contract. Meron tayong binayaran na 100,000. Oh, ang present value factor niyan ay piso. 1. Kasi the present value factor of 100,000 on that day is 100,000. Because the time value of money ano suggests that is the same on that day, no? 100,000 is 100,000. Kaya nga lang tayo nagkakaroon ng differences sa present value kasi finuforce natin ano, if we will be paying 100,000 next year, ano yung value niyan ngayon? Okay? After considering the time value of money. Kaya mas maliit yung halaga ngayon ng 100,000 mo next year. Okay? Sa 100,000 na yan ngayon. Alright. So, tignan po ninyo ano, if i-less natin yung present value factor of 1, kasi yan yung payment at the beginning, bawas natin yung 1, magkano yung matitira? Yung matitira po natin ay 0.9091. Now, pag hinanap po ninyo yan sa ating mga tables, no, present value factor tables, makikita po ninyo yan, ano? Saan ko po yan, sir, makikita? Makikita ninyo yan. Of course, baka makita nyo yan sa, pag tinignan ninyo yan, ano, mahahanap nyo po yan under the 10% column, okay? 10% interest, no? On that column, on period 1.9091. Okay? Ingat lang ha, baka may mga mamalik mata kayo kasi makikita nyo rin po sa 1% 0.9901. Okay ba po ito ha? This is 0.9091. So it should be found on your 10%, no, one period. Okay, that is why here I put here, I indicated that this also is your present value factor for the ordinary annuity at 10% in year one. Okay? Ibig sabihin, ang present value factor ko ngayon, nitong 100,000, okay, if I will compute the present value factor today, ang gagamitin ko pong present value factor ay 0.9091. I can find it in the present value factor table of an ordinary annuity at 10% in 1 year. So this will, I hope this clarifies some of the confusions, no, by many of the students. Kasi yung mga rates natin, yung mga present value factors, sometimes, we are talking about annuity due, pero yung presented sa mga problems, no, ay present value ng ordinary annuity. We can reconcile it because kahit na annuity due po yan, okay, one day difference lang naman. Ang payment mo hindi December 31, kung hindi January 1. But then, your present value factor for 1 year using 10% is the same, 0.9091. Because, if I will be paying it, isang araw lang naman na difference. Okay? Ingat, kasi pag tinignan po ninyo yung present value of an annuity due, 1% piso. Okay? Ang tinutukoy kasi ng present value ng annuity due at 1 using 10% is that eto lang yun kung 1. Eh dahil dalawang periods yan, eto siya. Okay? Tanggalin mo itong unang bayad at yung present value factor niyan ay 1. Okay? This is your 0.9091. Can you follow? If this is my 1, alright, this is my 0.9091. Okay? And that explains why the present value factor of an annuity due, ayan, palitin lang natin para mas nakikita po ninyo at na-appreciate ninyo siya. That is why the present value factor of an annuity due in 2 years is 1 plus 0.9091. Kaya makikita po ninyo, it's 1.9091. Remove the 1, the present value factor, for the remaining 100,000, even though this is an annuity due, you can still find this present value factor in an ordinary annuity table for the remaining 1 year. Okay? Alright? Can you understand? So I hope this clears out any misunderstanding or any confusion related to these computations or in identifying a present value. Okay, please let me know if ever you have any questions regarding this matter, and I'll be happy to accommodate or clear any misunderstanding or confusion on that subject. Thank you very much. Hanggang dito lamang. Bye-bye.